morning, the afternoon, the evening, night, depending on what part of the world you're in, of course. So I want to talk about what to do in the midst of the fire. So we all know the story of the three Hebrew boys who were named Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego. That wasn't their original name, but I won't talk about that today. But what I do want to talk about is the original inhabitants of the land. So the Akkadian Empire originally inhabited the land that was known as Babylon at one point, that is now known as Iraq. And those original inhabitants, in the beginning, they worshiped one god until they eventually adopted the beliefs of another culture who worshiped the god of the moon, the god of the sun, multiple gods, idol gods. And at that point, when they adopted this theology, their land was cursed. And even until this day, that land is still cursed. There have been fighting and wars and rumors and all of that stuff since then. So what we know that land to be is the Babylon land, because the Babylonian people came and they took over a very small village of people because of their disobedience, because they converted to worshiping multiple gods, and since then that land has been cursed. So what we know about the Babylonians is that they worship idol gods, that they worship statues, and they worship the moon and the sun and all of those things. And the original inhabitants of the land, they enslaved. So Babylon was a place that was known for luxury. They build a city on a hill. Seasonally, there were floods, and when the floods came in, they would destroy small villages. So Babylon strategically built their city on a hill so that when the seasonal floods came, they would be protected from the flood. So the enslaved people who were once inhabitants of the land, because of their disobedience, because they converted from believing in one God to believing in multiple gods, because of stuff that was introduced to them, their land was cursed. And people came in, wars came in, and they were overtaken, which started with their disbelief. So we know about the story of Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, and how King Nebuchadnezzar, who was one of the Babylonians, a descendant of the original Babylonians, who came in to inhabit, to steal the land. So Babylonian was a place that was policed. It was a place that had become oppressed by police brutality. Like, it was a dictatorship. Like, the people who came in and stole the land of the original small town forced everybody to believe what they believed. And if you didn't believe what they believed, you'd be killed. So King Nebuchadnezzar made a decree that at the sound of a horn, that everybody had to bow down and worship an image that his servants created. Imagine coming from descendants. Imagine being the descendants of people that originally worshiped one God, and you're being forced to build an image like the Washington Monument, where people had to worship, where people came, where elected officials and political figures came and bowed down to at the sound of a horn. Can you imagine the emotion that was going on while you're building? Anyways, fast forward, we don't have time for all of that. It's deep though. Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, they refused. This is not even their original name. This is a name that they were given by the Babylonians. But Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, as we know them, they refused to bow down to the man-made God. And because of that, King Nebuchadnezzar threw them in the fire. But prior to throwing them in the fire, he summons the guards to raise the fire 7 times higher. So while in the midst of the fire, chained, bound, the three Hebrew boys went back to their ancestors' belief. Well, they never left it, really, but they remembered their ancestors' belief, and they fell down to their face, and they worshipped. Although they were physically restricted, they weren't spiritually restricted. And because they weren't spiritually restricted, they remembered the God that was introduced to them, the all-powerful, all-knowing, all-seeing God. That same God sent his son in the midst of the fiery furnace. The very first thing he did is he noticed that they were bound while worshiping. A lot of us, we're worshiping, but we're bound physically, mentally, spiritually, emotionally. But in the midst of that, we're still worshiping, and God, he sees it. And because of that, he sends his son to our rescue, just like he sent his son to the rescue of those three Hebrew boys. So don't focus on your situation. Don't allow your situation to be your center. Don't allow finances to be your center. Don't allow your spouse, your job, your kids, your materialistic assets to be your center, but allow God to be your center. And when you allow God to be your center, he'll send his son to the rescue every time. So King Nebuchadnezzar, a man that believed in the idol gods, noticed that there was a fourth person in the fire. Puzzled and amazed and astonished, he asked the gods, "Did I tell you to cast three people there?" He said, "Yeah, we cast three people there. What's up?" "Oh, there's a fourth person there. And the fourth person looks like the Son of God." So Yahushua, Jesus, had entered the midst of the fiery furnace, had freed the Hebrew boys because of their faith. And now they were walking in the fire. Can you imagine a fire that is supposed to take you out? A fire that is supposed to destroy you? A fire that is supposed to kill you is not even restricting you anymore. Now that you're walking in it, because God was the center, he sent his son to a rescue. King Nebuchadnezzar at that point realized the power of God. So he ordered his guards to open the pit. He called unto the Hebrew boys and he told them to come forward. You know what they did? They walked boldly in the midst of the fire, out of the fire, in front of everybody, because King Nebuchadnezzar had summoned everybody to come to this town hall. Elected officials were there. Servants were there. Everybody was there. So everybody witnessed the power and the magnitude of God. King Nebuchadnezzar also witnessed that the three Hebrew boys, because of their faith, they were untouched and unharmed by the fire. Their clothes weren't even burned. Naturally, they were supposed to be dead, but spiritually they were protected because there was a cloud around them. And that cloud was the Most High Son, Jesus. King Nebuchadnezzar, at that point, promoted them and said that if anybody talked about them, that their punishment would be death. Don't focus on your fire. Focus on the center. And if God is your center, he'll send his son, Yahushua, Jesus, as a rescue. Stay encouraged. You got this. Because he is in the center. And as long as he is in the center, your promotion